Bum, 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 bum,
bum, okay. So, Brian, we use HubSpot to connect the dots between all the marketing efforts that we do and to actually measure success to understand what works and what doesn't work, right? So then if we are getting visits from Google and then they turn into leads and then they turn into customers, we can understand all of that. How do you connect the dots when you have phone calls in this whole mix of people that maybe they found you on Google and they go to the website, but instead of filling out a form or going through a bot, they just call?
Right. So from the digital side, there's so many ways for people to convert into leads. And you know, we use HubSpot, like you said, to track that activity so that we know people who are coming from our paid efforts, people who are coming from Google, like we know all that information. So from phone calls, like we really, that was kind of the challenge, is understanding how we can tie that together and how we can tie that into our digital efforts and be able to track all that activity, because a phone call is a conversion. A phone call is somebody, if somebody comes to your website, likes what they see, they might not want to fill out a contact form. They might want to call you right then and there. So we use CallRail, which allows us to set tracking phone tracking numbers on our website through like the dynamic phone swapping, which you can explain that a little bit more.
Yeah.
But and then also on print material. So if we don't necessarily do a lot of print advertising, but a lot, some of our clients do, and you can create tracking numbers on mailers, newspaper ads, and that allows us to understand not only how those activities are doing and how, you know, whether it's something that they should keep investing in, but we can also then track that activity once they come back to the website and get them into the database, knowing that and keeping all that data together.
And understand what works and what doesn't work.
Exactly.
Helping them on their outbound efforts. At the same time, we're tracking everything on the inbound side of things and these making decisions from the data. So
right.
The way the phone tracking and the connection with HubSpot works and their integration works is that when someone is on a website, HubSpot is already tracking where that person came from, the keyword, everything they can track, they're gonna be tracking. So if someone came from Google and they ended up on the website, and then they're going to all these pages, HubSpot is tracking all of that. Now, what CallRail does is instead of creating a lead on HubSpot when a form is submitted, which is what happens every time someone identifies themselves on the website, either through a form, a lead flow, a pop-up, or a chat conversation, when they identify themselves, when they give their name, email address, and things like that, that's when HubSpot creates a lead and it attaches all that history into that lead, right? Where the lead came from, the original source, if it was Google, if it was paid Google, if it was social media, if it was paid social media. So all of that goes in there, and then all the pages they went to and all the videos they viewed, if you're using the HubSpot with the integration, all those things. Now, when you have someone that calls directly, all of that doesn't happen. So what CallRail does is it shows different phone numbers to different people looking at the website right now. There's a pool of phone numbers they use, and they choose to show different phone numbers to different people, and then they connect the dots between this computer showing this phone number right now with this history to that phone call. So if someone decides to call, they're calling a specific number. Therefore, CallRail can make the connection between this cookie and this computer and this phone conversation. So then CallRail creates a lead inside HubSpot with that original source and that history connected to this phone call. And if you're tracking calls and if you're recording calls, the recording of the call also goes in there.
Right.
Now you can also tag calls, and CallRail allows you to create other things from the conversation. It actually analyzes the conversation. There's so much more that you can do with CallRail. It's an amazing integration. And it, like you were saying, you can also track all the calls from offline sources. But that's the way that CallRail and HubSpot integrate with each other, and it helps you connect the dots between these efforts.
And why it's important is it allows us and our clients to see the bigger picture. So, you know, when we're, you know, as an agency, when we're working with our clients, like we, you know, we give them advice and we try to like lead them in a direction that we think is the most beneficial and will give them the most return. Mm-hmm. So if people are, you know, from our paid advertisement coming in and making all these phone calls and we're not tracking that, then we're not reporting that. And that now we're not making the right decisions because we don't see that data. So giving them that full picture allows not only them to make the right decisions, but allows us to give the right advice and for us to make the right marketing decisions.
To actually close the loop on all the efforts, not just the efforts that end up in a form being filled up,
right,
and then a customer from there, but also phone calls, which are still a huge source of leads. Sometimes it's 20-30% of leads coming directly from phone calls. And that keeps growing over time because you have phone calls today that end up being leads or end up being customers months later, so we can analyze all that data and make decisions from it. So there's a problem, right, when this happens, because CallRail is creating leads inside HubSpot. Sometimes what happens is you get a repeated, you get a duplicate lead inside the database. So how do we deal with that?
Right, well, so in order for a lead to be created in HubSpot, we need an email address, mm-hmm. right? And so the way that CallRail creates contacts in HubSpot is it has the phone number and then at call.com for all the contacts that it creates. So if we don't have all that information of what their first name, last name is, what their email is, and it's creating these contacts, sometimes we get into that problem where now we have duplicate contacts.
Why do we have duplicates? Because they go back and they also fill out the form, for example.
Right, they may have called first and then later somewhere else they go to the website, fill out a form, and maybe they use a different phone number, or they use their husband's phone number, and then they put their phone number in the form, and so things don't match. And what ends up happening is that we have to now go in and try to figure out whose CallRail record is connected to what form submission. Mm-hmm. And you know, when you're talking about a database of 10,000 people, that gets really complicated.
Yeah.
And it really, you know, it's inundated with a mess. Mm-hmm. And also with HubSpot, it's a problem because you have to pay for contacts.
You have to pay for contacts, yeah. So that creates another 1,000 contacts, another $100, whatever it is that you pay for it.
Right. So one of the things that we do is we use a tool called InCycle, which it does a lot of things, but in this instance, it helps us clean that database and merge a lot of the duplicates. I don't know if you want to talk about that a little bit more.
Yeah, so what InCycle does is allows you to, when you are in the, it actually marks the merge, the duplicate entries, and then it shows the type of duplicate they are. They tell you what they're duplicated on. So if they have the same phone number or the same email, and then you can actually decide by rules,
right?
How you're gonna merge them. Do you wanna explain a little bit of the rules?
Yeah, so when you're merging duplicates, what you wanna do is you wanna define who the master is. And by defining who the master is, like for us, it's really important that we know where they originally came from. So we usually do it by original source. So if original source is organic, or then we can, that's something we wanna, well, that's the person we wanna hold on to. So what we can do is match it by the phone number, but then we set the rules that if the original source is organic, that's, we want that one to be the master. If lead activity was the most recent or whatever, that we want to keep that person because that's somebody that's actively coming to the website. We're tracking that data. So yeah, you can just kind of create these rules so that you're not losing any data.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're just taking two profiles, putting them together, but making sure that you're keeping the most relevant information.
That's awesome.
And the important information to report on.
Awesome. So the other thing, the other side of the phone call is the sales activities. And for this, we use AirCall. And AirCall is an amazing tool. Also, it also integrates into HubSpot. And what it does is it allows us to create our own phone system for the sales team. So the sales team can have their own phone system. It's all tracked. Everything goes automatically into HubSpot. So every phone call they receive or they make is going to be tracked on HubSpot. It's going to go in HubSpot as the phone call. It's going to track it as a sales activity, which is very important when you're analyzing sales teams and you're trying to manage sales teams to see how many calls they made, how many emails they make. You can always do this internally in HubSpot. You can connect your cell phone into HubSpot and then call from the website. But all of that is sometimes cumbersome, and salespeople do calls from their phone, from their car, from their home. So not always, they don't always have the ability to do it from the tool. So then they're not tracking everything they're doing, and then measurement and you know, reports are gonna be skewed. So what AirCall does is it connects, it creates the phone system for your sales team, and you can use it for your whole company. And then you allow it allows you to track every phone call, incoming and outgoing, from that sales team. What happens is it's tracked automatically, and then you can also, if the recordings go in there if you're recording, and you can also create tags. So the sales team can tag the call as soon as they finish. They allow you to then make decisions depending on the tag. So you can create custom programming for a specific sales team to do automation depending on where the call came from or what is tagged on and if it goes to another person. So there's a lot that you can do. Again, these integrations have a lot of complexity, but the basics of it, it's amazing already.
Yeah, and another benefit too of AirCall is that it's all in the cloud, right? It's a software that's all over the internet. So, you know, a lot of businesses are changing the way they do business, and mm-hmm. people are working from home, or, you know, they have remote, people are everywhere throughout the country or throughout the world. And so AirCall allows you to kind of keep that, you can have it on your laptop, you can have it on your phone, you
exactly.
can be connected anywhere. And yeah, and having it integrated into HubSpot is perfect for us.
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot of people are using HubSpot, and a lot of people need that, keep that data together.
Yeah, and like Brian was saying, you can have it on your computer, and you can take calls from your computer, and it pops out automatically when there's a call, and it tells you what kind of number it is, what area code, and actually tells you the lead associated with that phone number on the app, and you can click on that lead, mm-hmm. and it takes you automatically into that HubSpot lead. So when you're picking up a phone call, you have all the history inside HubSpot for that specific lead. So this is a very useful tool for sales teams and salespeople when they're trying to make phone calls and receive phone calls. The other thing is it also works on your cell phone, and it allows people to make phone calls from the main line, which is a big deal when you're managing a business. You don't want a bunch of people to have different phone numbers and then receiving calls on their cell phones, and then people calling people on their cell phones. So you can integrate everything into your phone numbers, and then every time you make a phone call, even if it's from your cell phone, since you're using the AirCall app, it comes from the main line or it comes from the sales line. So then when someone calls back, they're calling the same line, they're not calling someone's cell phone.
You might have mentioned this already, but also, like, if let's say you're working with a prospect, and you know, maybe you haven't heard from them in a couple weeks or something, but they call, that prospect will come up on the phone line, and it'll come to you because it's yours.
Exactly.
And now you're picking up the phone and having a conversation with him, and you know it's him. You can address him or that person, you know, however you want. And then when you're done with the phone call, you're leaving notes on how that phone call went or whatever that next process is.
Yeah. So on the marketing and on the sales side of things, phone calls are important, and we are using CallRail, AirCall, and InsightCall to help our customers get the big picture of everything, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. Perfect. Great talk.